Hi, Kathy.
I see. Okay, so we're going to tell the story of wet luggage?
Yes.
On Carnival, and I'm sure other ships do the same thing, but anyway, the night before, you pack everything up, you put everything except what you're going to sleep in and wear the next day out in your suitcase, and you put them outside, out in the hallway. So we did that Saturday night, and then we get up and get moving on Sunday. And we had dinner that night at the steakhouse, and it cost a little bit extra, but we wanted, and at that time, the tip was included, but we wanted to give the lady a little more tip. And so Terry goes, and it wouldn't, for some reason, the sale and sign card wouldn't work at the steakhouse. And so he goes down to guest services and tries to give a tip, and they can't get it to work either. So eventually he just ends up clearing out our account for the week and being finished with it. And they give him a check for a little bit of money, and he comes back up and we go to bed. So we get up on Sunday. We're going to meet everybody. Our cruise group, our friends, we're going to meet them at 9 o'clock for breakfast. But when they slipped the bill under the door during the night, instead of it having a zero balance, it showed the $35 that he had tried to give as a tip. It now showed that we owed $35. So Terry goes down to guest services, stands in this long line of all these millions of people that are trying to clear out their bill, gets that straightened out, and comes back upstairs, and I have finished packing the last little bit, you know, pajamas and whatever, toothbrush, and getting ready to go have breakfast, when over the loudspeaker we hear, "Guests Terry and Kathy Havens, please come to guest services." And so we kind of look, and, you know, what in the world, and they repeat it, and so, okay, fine. So Terry said,
"Rest of us are upstairs in the dining room, and we are waiting for the Havens to come for breakfast, and we hear this announcement, and we're like, what could be wrong?"
And, you know, we've talked to our kids once we're in port, so we know that they're fine, and my dad had developed pneumonia, was in the hospital, but we've talked to him, he's fine. What in the world? So Terry said, "I wonder if there's something else with the bill." And he said, "Do you want to go with me?" And I said, "Yeah, let's just go on down there. And then that way we'll just go to breakfast." We get down there and we wait in line and we tell this person, you know, who we are. And the little girl looks up. She looks down. She looks over here. Okay, it's never a good sign when they won't look in the eye. You know, you just know. And she's got her little hands out in front of her. She looks like she's praying. And she says, "I'll be right back." And so she leaves. And she's gone for a couple of minutes. And she comes back and she said, "Somebody will be with you in a minute." And she's still kind of looking up at the air. Well, in another couple of minutes, here comes this guy, except he's on the outside where we are. And he comes around and he said, "Mr. and Mrs. Havens?" And we said, "Yes." And he said, "I need you to follow me." And again, looks like he's praying because he's not looking at us. So we follow him, and he takes us down the hall to where it's all wood on the hallway, except that he pushes the door, and it's a door. And so it's like a secret door. And so we go in, and we are now in the bowels of the purser's department. And he takes us past all these people, and way at the back, he takes us in, and there's a man standing there, and he is the chief purser. And he is got a bead of sweat up here. And he's very British, and he's just standing like this. And, okay, this is not a good sign, guys. So we go in and we sit down, and I'm sitting directly across from him, and Terry is at an angle in a chair, so I can only see this man. Terry sees both of us. And so he puts his hands on his desk, and he takes a big breath, and he kind of sighs. And finally he says, "I have some rather bad news." And, okay. And in my head I'm thinking again, we've talked to the kids, we've talked to Daddy, we've talked to Terry. What bad news can you have? He says, "There seems to have been a little accident with your luggage." And Terry and I look at him. I said, "I beg your pardon?" And he says, "It seems that there was an accident and two pieces of your luggage have fallen into the gulf." into the water. And I turn and look at Terry, and he looks at me, and we both burst into laughter. Oh, and Terry said, because now I'm looking at Terry, Terry said that out of the corner of his eye, he sees this guy, and his whole body language just... We found out later that he had only been chief purser for a week. We were his first emergency. No, 2 weeks. We were his first emergency. I am so glad that it was us because we thought it was funny. I mean, we laughed. And instead of somebody coming over the table, like Terry said, he figures that guy thought that he was about to get beat up. And so they took us... And he said, we found one bag, but the other one we didn't recover. And they have nets, and so it fell into the net, and they were, and it popped back up, and they were able to fish it out. But the other one, there's a space in between the dock and the netting, and it went blub, blub, blub to the deep blue sea, except in Galveston, you know, it's brown sea. But anyway, except last week.
Except for recently.
Last week when it was, except for last week when it was blue. Anyway, they took us downstairs and they opened the bag so that we can confirm, yes, it's ours. And it obviously fell this way because from here down was wet, but from here up was dry. So we opened it up and it's beginning to wick. And so we took out the Bible and he told me later, he said, I knew when the only thing that you were concerned about was your Bible, was that you were really good people. You weren't upset about anything, but you did take the Bible out so it didn't get wet. And so we closed it back up, and they were going to send it through customs, and then we would catch up with it on the other end after we left. And so we told him, he asked if we were ready to leave, and we said, no, we were going to breakfast. And so he said, when you get ready to leave the ship, come back here, and we'll escort you off. Before we left him, he had already told us, he had already put into the system that this had happened, that they were giving us a... I call it a half-price cruise, but in reality, they paid for one of us, and we paid for the other one of us. Mm-hmm. To me, that's half-price. Terry assures me that's not half-price.
At the price, or at the room level,
Exactly. And we were in a suite, so we were going to have the exact same thing again the next. And so we'd already decided we wanted to take another cruise. We just didn't realize it was going to be half of it be Carnival taking care of it. And so we go upstairs to the Lido deck, and we find our friends to have breakfast. And when we get there, they're all standing up yelling, what happened? What happened?
Kept hearing your name. We kept hearing your name.
So that's where you come in.
So you said our one piece of luggage got baptized.
Two.
I remember that.
Our luggage got baptized. And so we began to explain what happened, and there's never been as much hilarity taking place as what took place at that breakfast table. Everybody, and probably because we were already laughing about it, then everybody else was able to laugh about it. But it was, you know, everybody was laughing and talking about it.
So we had a nice breakfast, and then we debarked.
And we had our picture taken with the cruise director. Do you remember that?
Yes, we did.
We got to have our picture taken because when we went back to the purser's purser's desk to have them take us off the ship, he was standing there, and when he heard, he said, oh, you're the ones. I heard about that. And what happened? And so Terry and I are telling him, and he said something about, well, you're taking it really well, and we laughed. And so then everybody else laughed about how, you know, what we had said about the bag being baptized and all the different things. Anyway, so we had our picture taken with him. I still have the picture.
Yeah.
And then we get off the ship, and because we stayed so long at breakfast, there were few bags left out there. So Larry and I found our bags, except for one. And then I go up to a lady that's working there, and I said, we're missing a bag. And she said, oh, way down there. That's where all the single bags are. You'll find your bag down there. So I went walking way down, and I'm looking at all the bags, and none of them are ours. And then Kathy shows up.
Well, because y'all ended up having to leave the ship without us, because when we got back to the purser's desk, they didn't have somebody to take us off yet. So you guys all left, and we waited. So the second purser was the person who escorted us off, and so she took us to where our bags were, and I told Terry before we were ever to the luggage, all of our luggage is there except the one we've already seen. Now, we're supposed to be missing two, remember? But I'm counting, and we get up there to them, and I said, no, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We had 6 bags. Here's 5 of them. We know where one is. And I'm telling her, this is all. She said, well, are you sure? Well, yeah, pretty much. I do know what my suitcases looked like, you know. Yeah, am I sure? And so I said, no, here's my little luggage tags right here. Here's 6 luggage tags. One is in customs already wet, and here are the other 5.
And I'm hearing this.
And so as we're standing there, here come Larry and Sue, and Larry says to us, we've got a bag missing. And he raises his hand and goes, I know where it is. And then the little girl, the purser, looks at Larry and Sue, and Terry and I like, what? And Terry says, they were next door to us. I think they have the other bag. I think their bag is what. And she said, but the guy kept saying they were matched luggage. And I said, well, technically they did match all of theirs, and ours matched all of ours, but they didn't match each other.
And they gave me a little bit of a rough time as far as, how do you know that your bag went overboard? Well, this couple were told that 2 bags fell overboard. Only one of theirs fell over, so the other one is ours. How do you know it fell overboard? It's just lost.
Yeah, at one point she actually asked Sue, why did you throw your bag overboard into the Gulf? Well, you know, it was Sunday. We just thought it would be a good idea. That was the dumbest. I mean, of all the positives, that had to be the bonehead comment of the whole thing.
So we know what's going on, and I've got Kathy's number, and we go home. And I call Carnival, telling them the story, and we need some reimbursement. And she's not too hip on doing that. And so I call Kathy, and I go, okay, tell me everything that you're going to get out of this.
Yeah.
And she's going to get this cruise with one person paid for.
A cruise, and they paid for all of the luggage, all of the t-shirts, all of the clothing that was damaged inside of it. Terry's shoes needed to be replaced. They paid for new shoes. They paid in all, and I kept saying, do you need me to send you receipts? No, no, ma'am, we trust you. The purser's written a note here about how the only thing you took out of there was your Bible and that we should trust you. I am delighted that he took us that honest, but there's a part of me that thinks, oh, please don't other people just stick a Bible inside something and try and cheat just because you got a Bible with you. But he had given us a card, and it had a case number and all that kind of stuff, and so I was able to give Sue our case number, and so she could call them back and talk to the lady that I had talked to, that I had her number, and be able to talk to somebody with some good sense.
Right, and so I called, and giving them the case number really helped us.
Yeah.
And so we got the same offer, and they started to believe me that it was our suitcase that went overboard.
And that you didn't throw it overboard.
Right. And I said, just go back and check with everyone. 2 went over, and the other one was ours. And we had Larry's razor. We had some of my blouses that had metal buttons. And I'm like, I'm going to have some destroyed clothes.
Yeah.
And so
they sent a diver.
Right. Now, So they reimbursed us for the razor and the luggage, and we had to provide receipts for every single item.
See, they didn't even ask me for receipts.
They didn't
ask me for any receipts, and by the time it was all said and done with, I only needed to replace one piece of luggage, but the amount of money that they were willing to give us, I bought a whole set of new luggage on sale, because who knew January was luggage month sale?
Yeah.
And so so if you ever buy luggage, do it in January, because that apparently is the month. But I got a whole new set of luggage.
I got one piece.
For what they paid us for that one piece.
Because I had to provide receipts for everything.
Yeah, I had forgotten about the diver.
And then about 6 weeks later, we're coming down the road and to our house, and there's a FedEx truck stopped in front of our house. And we're like, did you buy something? No.
Wasn't that when you'd broken your wrist and you were just getting out of the hospital?
That's what I was thinking. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So each of us said, we didn't order anything. And then out comes this blue bag. It was our lost luggage. They sent a diver down there to retrieve our luggage. I thought they were just going to leave it, but they retrieved it and they sent it to us.